This problem asks us to balance a redox reaction and oxidation reduction reaction. And now this is in basic solution and is asking what's the coefficient of water, the stoichiometric coefficient in this balanced reaction. And so the procedure we're going to use is first to write down half reactions. Essentially, one is an oxidation and one is a reduction. Here's one half reaction, and the other is the oxidation state of chlorine changing. Next step is to balance oxygen by adding water. In this case, to the left side, four oxygens on the left, we need three waters. And then we want to balance hydrogen, and we'll do that by adding H+. So that's to the right side to balance the six hydrogens on the left, six hydrogen ions on the right. We don't have to do anything to the second equation. Next, we want to balance charge. Charge needs to be the same on both sides. So we want to balance charge, and we're going to do that by adding electrons. The second equation, charge is -2 on the right, so we need two electrons on the left. We have a charge of -2 on the left side of the first equation, and we charge of -2 + 6, so that's +4. So that means we need to add 6 electrons, so the charge is -2 on both sides. Let's double check that. -6 + 6, so then the charge balances. And then what we're going to do is add these two equations. So next step is to recombine the two half reactions. But we want to do that so we balance the electrons, so the electrons disappear from the overall reaction. So that means I'm going to take this reaction times 1, this reaction times 3. And so let's write that down, combining left sides and right sides. So I've done that here, and then the electrons cancel out, and I have an equation where my last step is to verify, and by that I mean on the left side I have 6 hydrogen atoms, and on the right side I have 6 hydrogens. Left side 1 selenium, right side 1 selenium. The left I have 3 oxygens plus 1, 4 oxygens, right side 4 oxygen atoms. And then left 6 chlorine atoms, and the right 6 chlorine atoms. And then the final check is the charge, -2 on the left, and -2 on the right, since the 6 plus 6 and the -6 cancel. So the equation checks. Now the final step, however, very important one, this is in basic solution. Right now the way it's written is in acidic solution. So when it's basic solution, there's a 6th step, and that's that we add OH minus. So we add OH minus to cancel out the H plus, but we have to, of course, add that to both sides of the equation. So I would add 6 OH minus here and 6 OH minus here. Not quite finished, because now the H plus plus OH minus go to form water, and we're going to end up with water on both sides of the equation. We need to cancel out, so we don't have species that are not actually involved in the reaction. So let's rewrite this equation. So notice that I combine the H plus and the OH minus to make 6 waters. Then I would cancel, subtract 3 waters from the left side, 3 from the right, so I end up with 3 waters in my final equation. So here's the final equation, basic solution. The original question asked, what's the stoichiometric coefficient from water? The answer then would be 3.